There are many people who are well-known environmentalists who are working on this problem and have made tremendous contributions to raising awareness and consciousness about it, and have worked hard to sort of wake the world up to the necessity of doing something before it's too late. Jim Hansen is one. He is a famous person in the United States who was, you know, had an important government position. And he testified, he made a very famous testimony before the U.S. Congress saying, we now know, you know, your scientific employees working for your best agencies on this subject, we now know that there really is global warming going on, that it really is a serious threat, and that is primarily anthropocentrically caused, that it's human economic activity, the burning of fossil fuels, that's doing it. I mean, this was a huge deal in the United States to have, this is the official government position on it. And of course, it sparks the whole denialist, well, the Republicans and the Republicans simply refuse to say it. He's wrong. So he's played an incredibly important role. And he signed a letter with two other people of that kind recently, an open letter to the environmental movement saying, please reconsider your opposition to nuclear power, to expanding nuclear power. He said, I've been with you in the past, but the climate situation is sufficiently serious and imminent that it really requires us to reconsider all of our conclusions about priorities and what risks we're willing to take. And so he urged a reconsideration. A guy named Stuart Brand wrote a book and was touring the United States. And amongst other things, he also had a chapter in his book saying, hey, I was a anti-nuclear activist in my youth. It made sense back then. This stuff's dangerous. Why are we doing this? But now it seems to me that we actually are desperate enough to reduce carbon fuel emissions so that we have to, you know, we need to reconsider. So there are people who have raised this, you know, whose credentials, these are not people who are shills for the nuclear power industry. This isn't General Electric or somebody whose research is funded by General Electric who's going to build all these plants and wants the world to go nuclear and that's the response. And people should understand, I mean, that is quite predictably happening. There's a powerful lobby out there that wants to build these nuclear plants. It's very good. It's very lucrative, profitable business. In a lot of ways, it's sort of a part of this incredibly powerful military-industrial complex. It sort of fits into that whole, you know, way of going about business. So, in my opinion, they are taking sort of, they are shamelessly, in a very self-interested way, taking advantage of rising awareness of the climate crisis to basically just push, you know, to get what they've always wanted, which is permission to do more nuclear plants with big cost overruns and huge profit margins. But what I'm saying is that we now have people who have always been with us on these issues saying, doesn't this need reconsideration? I think they're right that logically, if you are far more concerned about the risk of climate change than you were in the past, not because you shouldn't have been in the past, you just weren't. You made a mistake and now the new information lets us realize. But if we now realize that we should be far more concerned about climate change than in the past when we said, well, we don't need nuclear power, doesn't that imply that there's a reconsideration in order? Yes. So I would concede that. We should rethink it. But when I rethink it, I come to the same conclusion, which is this is still not the best way and the right way to respond to climate change. And the reason is rather simple. There's improvements in technologies, but the essential problems are still there. I mean, the dangers of nuclear power have not gone away. There's no solution for the waste problem. That still remains unsolved. And if there'd been a solution for the waste problem, it's been a long time. So why should we believe that we are any closer to a solution to the waste problem when nobody has anything concrete to say on the subject and they've had all these years to come up with an answer? And we have the Fukushima accident to remind us that is still a ticking bomb over there. That place is still incredibly dangerous. There can be more. All sorts of things can go wrong right there at that site that are going to create incredible problems. Do we really need, so what it comes down to, are we so desperate that we really need to run that kind of risk? Well, how much good does the nuclear power do? Well, right now, when I read the studies, what I see is we can expand non-nuclear, non-fossil fuel energy production faster and cheaper than we could build new nuclear plants. That it's just not the efficient way to replace fossil fuels. It's too slow and it's too expensive. Now, if we didn't have wind and solar and energy conservation available to us, well then, yes, we would be stuck with that. But we have all that, and all of the studies, all of the information, all of the cost estimates are basically telling us that that's the expensive, slow way to solve the problem. It's the way that some very powerful interests and lobby groups would like to have us solve it. But I think it would be a terrible mistake, you know, as for us to buy into that. I don't think that's actually the effective solution.